Hello, I'm Mr. R. Nitya, a retired lecturer in metallurgy preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I want to stress, you know, that many people who talk about sins and Lord and all that thing, you know, they are talking about rabbinic system, and when the rabbis were ruling, they were ruler, you know, as Nicodemus was a ruler. So at that time, you know, people were asked to go by the moral laws of Moses. Moses was a man and not of the God. But Moses, he had put on Christ. Christ means his word. So in the light of his word, Moses then dictated the moral laws. So that is what we call the oral Torah, Christ. So what is moral laws are? They are written Torah. And written Torah is written with the light of God. So that is called oral Torah, light of God. But when the priest become greedy, rabbinic people become greedy, they love mammon, then they become antichrist. That means they start cheating people, fleecing them, they become hypocrites. So when they become hypocrites, which are antichrist, then God sends his own priest, which is royal priest, and which is Christ, and that his name was Jesus. So Christ was the title and not the name. So when he comes, then he fights against the antichrist, and then he sheds his own blood to cleanse the heart of the people, to open the gate to the God himself. That is why the curtain of the holiest of holy was torn apart. Before, people were kept alienated from God by the rending of the curtain. He has exposed the secrets of our Father God. So he has joined us with God. And they were priest, and in Jesus we become royal priest. So Christ Jesus, he was a royal king. Not a king as these people proclaim, because they are men of flesh. They only know the things of flesh. In the kingdom of the flesh, you have the kings and queens and all that who sit in pomp and show, who put on crowns which are made of gold, silver, and rubies, diamond, etc., artificial material. But our royal priest, Christ Jesus, had a crown of thorn, not made of artificial material, but of the living natural material. That means these natural men, they are the one, they kill Christ because they do not know Christ. And because they do not know Christ, they are forgiven. If you know that he is the Christ, then you are working against the Holy Spirit. It is through Spirit that you know Christ. So those temple priests, they had the Spirit, but it was evil. And through that evil spirit, they knew Christ Jesus is the Christ. He is the Son of God who has come to take the revenue of the wine press. You want to take the fruit of the wine press. but they were not producing any fruit that is symbolized by the fig tree, which was having beautiful leaves but no fruit. Same temple was having beautiful building, gold and all that, to attract people, as Pope has got a big empire in Rome to attract people, but no fruit. That empire is of Antichrist, worse than those temple rabbis. So Jesus, with his blood, he set us free. And those who are people of spirit, they enjoy it, because this is the age which is of spirit, and in spirit and in truth, you first worship our Father, God. Your temple is no more built of brick and mortar, but is built of by nature, which is the best temple you can have. So, old temple gone, old utensils gone, old ritual gone. So, we have been seated into the new temple of God, which is our physical body. And heart is the seat for the royal priest, Christ Jesus. So, in his honor, in the honor of Christ Jesus, we preach gospel, as in the honor of the second anointed Christ, Nanak, in India, the Sikhs preach gospel in honor of Nanak, not in their own honors or in their own names. Whereas the saints in India, such as Kabir, Bhakti Ravdas, and other people, because they attained oneness with God through meditation, through their own efforts. So they worship God in their own names. So when all these Satgurus, after Satguru Nanak, we had five Satgurus, and all mention the name of, they all do the work of Christ Nanak. Christ means Satguru. So they worship him. Worship our Father God. So in Jesus, he came to introduce our Father in truth and in spirit, and we worship our Father God in honor of Christ Jesus, who has introduced to us our Father. Remember, if you have a lecturer or chemistry professor who has taught you chemistry, and whenever you perform any duties regarding your profession, then you always honor that professor who taught you the subject of chemistry. So similarly, we honor our anointed elder brother Christ Jesus for preaching us the gospel of our Father. So it is the gospel that unite us with our Father, not the idol or statue of Christ Jesus. As I explained earlier, these dead in spirit people, when they had killed the apostles, these Messianic Jews, they created blind guides of the blind, and then they put to them the statues of Mary, Jesus, and icon of even Paul, who even had a good fight with the one who was making the idols. And when I went to the St. Paul Cathedral in London, and I asked their priest, where is St. Paul? They showed me one outside this, his one statue is there, and one is where we worship inside, but you can't go and see him, you know. So they had these statues of St. Paul, idols. And if St. Paul turns up in his own church, St. Paul, which they call it in London, he won't be happy. He will beat them up. Those people, they worship not God, but Mammon. The head of the Church of England is Queen. Queen is the head of Mammon. So that is how, you know, people are misled. And those people who are not intelligent, who are once born, who do not know what is sin and what is not sin, and they feed on scripture, they feed on milk. Milk is the scripture. Those people, they are not hypocrite. They are, for they don't know what God is or what is hypocrisy, so they are forgiven. Same Saul, he was like that, you know. He was persecuting the workers of Christ Jesus, but his heart was clean. But what he was doing was against his conscience. So that's why, you know, Christ Jesus being merciful, then he asked Paul, "Paul, Paul, why are you persecuting me?" And then the thickness of the scales that came out of his eyes showed the thickness of darkness in which he was living. So when his eyes were opened, he's opened into the third, he was fourth eye, you know, which is one with God, which is he possessed the then very spirit of God, the same as the apostles had it at Pentecost. So when Paul had the Holy Spirit with capital S, from blindness to Holy Spirit, a great jump, then he was one with God. What came out of his mouth, it was he spokesman of God. He was no more a learner like you and me. He became a spokesman of God. That's why he did not need to go to Jerusalem to learn the subject, because God has given him straight from his own treasury. So same, you know, when Jesus was in Jerusalem, Gospel of John 9, when the blind man's eyes was opened, and Jesus said to some people that talked about sin, the one standing by, "Do you think we are the sinners?" Then Jesus said, "No, you know, you are no more children. You know what is sin and what is not sin. So you are twice born. You are not under the regime of sin, but you come under the regime of hypocrisy." So people who knowingly do wrong things, they are hypocrites. That's why Jesus said, "Do what the Pharisee and Sadducee tell you to do, but don't follow their example, because they are hypocrites." At the same time, Christ Jesus said, you know, that I'm cleansing the heart of the people with my blood, acting as the Lamb of God. I'm giving my sacrifice. And the effect was that in the villages, people start killing these Jews, and they were made to run to Jerusalem. So much was hatred against the Jews. But when the Church of God was formed, these very Jews, they entered into that one. And these added spirits, Matthew 12:43-45, then put on these robes of bishops and other thing, and they put on yokes on the people that was worse than from which our anointed elder brother Christ said, Jesus set them free. So the situation became worse than before. So today, the situation is worse than when rabbis and temple priests were dominating, and Christ Jesus came. And God, our Father, bless you.